This is my day. This is my day. I'm gonna do things my way. This is my day. I'm gonna do things my way. If you believe it,
say it.
You're gonna make it,
say it.
If you believe it,
say it.
This is my day.
To muster around the third table. It's nearly the weekend, baby. But yeah, we have survived the very first week of 2017. Can we say yeah?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah.
We may not be live tonight, but we are streaming live to you on TrendingSA.tv, and we are always live on all our social media handles. Just by tagging hashtag #Tsaon3, you'll get to interact with the show's handles and also ask the baddest crew on the small screen. What are the names of the crew? I don't know, because they all look alike. No, they don't. Nomani Nagazi, Nina Hasty on my right. Mama, oh, Titi, oh, Shalala, shake those shoulders when I'm mama. Let's do it again when I'm mama. Shalala, yo, Titi, yo, mama. Ah, Mr. President. In the opposite corner is our shade and litness, Shaka Susulu, the hottest man, the hottest man. Yes, the hottest man on the planet. Look at him. Look at him. Dark chocolate. And of course, ladies, you do know that he's very single and he's very eager. Right next to me, ending his visit with us this week is our guest host and fan base host, Akumzi, the beautiful and the awesome and the talented Akumzi. And of course, as you know, guys, my name is Kensani Nkosi. No, it is Unati Nkai. No, it is Shubimboya. No, guys, Kuli Rame. It's time to share what we have on our timelines. Come on, guys, let's start with you, Akumzi.
Well, everyone knows about your Friday, apparently. Everyone that watches the show knows Good Training SA has to be wrapped up with flashing back with the latest chillest post that we found on the streets of social media. Now, many of you guys thought that no chill will be something we're leaving behind in 2016, but it actually crossed over with us to the new year, and we'll be checking out some of the chillest posts that we recently posted. If you posted something that is chillest, you might just see it on the show tonight.
Yeah, guys, we do encourage that you continue to who cares because it scares us.
No one has time for chill.
No one has time for chill. I mean, please. Shakalalas, you have some English to speak.
Yeah.
Speak it.
Yeah, because I'm going to teach you history.
Hello.
Yeah, we're going to go back in time.
Uh-huh.
Way back. Back into time. Oh, no, 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 no. With meme history. All right, so this hashtag meme history. We're going to look at the history of the world through memes. How crazy is that? How crazy are you guys for putting it together?
Also, next time you post something chillers, of course, like you said, tag us on Tsaon3 so we can share it with the nation. This year, we are introducing Training SA Memes Hall of Fame, guys. You know that you like things and you know you want to be there. So you can share your favorite memes by tagging, and we may put them on blast and add them to our Cyber Hall of Fame. It is called Tsaon3. That is the hashtag. My name is Kuli Roberts. Nina, you have some music. Lady of the night. You got music. Gives the people.
We're insane. Okay, so most definitely, my sister Kuli, we have a little turn up in this place,
y'all.
Because you know we're like a turn up. I brought a friend. Okay, he's not a friend yet. Someone I just met once, but it's not going down in the DMs yet. Let's see if you guys can guess who this rapper is. Okay. He was born in Durban. All right. He
Zambia.
He was.
No.
He's a bit old for me.
Wow.
All right. I'm joking.
Nomsawa is old.
He's an award-winning record producer. His real name is Tumelo Thandokuhle Mathebula.
Is he gay?
Tumelo.
No, but he certainly needs an AKA. He's simply known as Sweezy, everyone! And he's here!
Nice. More music tonight. Hashtag 100 heartbreaking lyrics was trending this week. And I thought about all those who lost their partners due to the summer flings who came in to steal their lovers over the holidays. I'm sure they enjoyed being stolen as well. They left you heartbroken. And as they make their comeback this week, asking for forgiveness and alone, we've got some heartbreaking lyrics for you to clap back with. The tables are turning. It's a new year start over. That's hashtag 100 heartbreaking lyrics. Other hashtag that also trended this week, but we never got to talk to them, were hashtag Mzansi Facts as well as hashtag Chris Brown. We'll talk about them after the break, so join the conversation. You know what it is? It is hashtag Tsao on 3. On Twitter, it is TrendingSA on 3. What do you think it is on Instagram?
On Instagram, it has to be TrendingSA.
What about Facebook?
On Facebook, it has to be TrendingSA.
Look at this man. What's the hashtag, Lala?
The hashtag is TSA on 3.
Yeah. I mean, guys, come on, guys. He's only been here for 2 days and he's got it. We'll be back after the break. You are a genius. How did you remember, though? Did you write it down? Oh, my God. I'm going to make it again.
This is my day. This is my day.
Shonina. Yes, girl.
Breadwinners of today, you are watching TrendingSA. If it's trending on your timeline, retweeted, reposted, subtweeted, your best is going to be dissected right here on the show. We start with hashtag Chris Brown. Age these guys. They must just go to school and stop being so, like, pedestrian.
Look, it's a thing. You got hip-hop. They're always fighting. They're always beefing and always doing all sorts of things. So Soulja Boy and Chris Brown are trending
Soulja Boy.
That one, yeah. They're trending because of the internet beef between the two of them. So it all started when Soulja Boy liked Instagram photos of his ex-girlfriend, yaka Chris Brown.
The ex. Not even a current.
Like a past ex.
That girl looks like she's never eaten a carb in her whole life.
She probably has. I mean, she probably...
As you were saying.
So after Chris Brown saw the likes, Chris Brown went and challenged Soulja Boy to a boxing match.
Yes.
Now that's real.
What do you mean? Why?
Because what are you doing liking my ex's photos?
Like, if I had to double click any of Pila's pictures.
So whoever that person is, yes. I don't know what he's talking about.
We don't know.
Back to my story,
what's
Shaka.
In his cup?
Okay. Shaka said I don't have it. Don't let so anyway, so he apparently, so Soulja Boy says apparently there's a guy that robbed him, and he met because he thought it was Chris Brown.
But these guys had collaborated a couple of months or weeks ago. How can you not know?
I don't know. Maybe by Bonba Wednesday, I don't know. But so there's a Twitter rant that's happening between the two of them.
A publicity stunt.
Okay, you can tell that, say that in 2 seconds. Continue.
So there's a Twitter rant that's happening between the Soulja Boy and Chris Brown. And they're also threatening each other with guns. So they really are taking it straight to the street. Would have loved to show everyone at home this tweet, or rather this whole thread on Twitter. But it's quite, it's colourful, for lack of a better term.
That's colourful.
It's the whole thread, the conversation. Right. So, but you can log on. You can log on social media and follow the thread if you'd like to see what exactly is happening. But it looks like it's happening. It's going down. We're going to put it up.
Can we blur it out?
Let's see.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so that's the video.
Those are toy pistols. Guns. They're water pistols.
They do not look like toy guns
at all. That's a BB gun.
Those are toy guns.
Yeah.
Listen, so, my cousin's got Uzis. Calm down.
I just think that those are the guys who give black people a bad name
those
in the States.
Those are nice jeans.
Walking around with guns. Nanga, you continue in a sweetie. Stop talking, winner.
That's so boring. Anyway, so Tweet Guru has gotten hashtags to trend. We love Tweet Guru. Okay, his little face. All right, so the first one is where he challenged folks earlier today on Twitter under the hashtag Facts About Mzansi. So he asked people to post facts about Mzansi. Check this first one out. So Tweet Guru says, what are some of the things you know about our beloved country? No lies, please! Hashtag Facts About Mzansi. Froggy face, flame. And then the responses, Tweeps took up the challenge and tweeting facts to check, there were tongue-in-cheek facts about Mzansi, and here are some of the tweets.
Tongue-in-cheek?
Real ones. Okay, facts about Mzansi, you will never get a high-paying job that only requires matric if you don't bribe. Muzi says, where we have more English teachers on Twitter than in schools. Hashtag facts about Mzansi. That's deep, guys.
Everyone's like a grandma granny.
I know.
Yeah, you say the thing wrong. It's not an easy R.
Do you remember that time that someone was correcting my Zulu spelling on Twitter and then didn't spell right in English? Anyway, it was funny. Also, like yesterday when someone told me I was a great raper.
But they meant rapper.
Yeah,
now for the future, we have every single Friday. It's Zero Chill Friday. We love it. You love it. Yes, it's time for us to dive into our Zero Chill pool of posts and see some of those that has left us less than deserving of the internet. Akumzi, man with no chill, smiley son. That's the man with no chill, actually.
Shaka.
Shaka.
So this is indeed correct.
Look how chill I am. Look how chill I am.
That's the chill.
I'm so chill.
My goodness.
I'm like still more Ricky vibes.
Yeah.
What?
Like, I ain't got a care in the world. I ain't got debit orders that bounced.
Me neither.
Okay. I got 39,644 rand with my account, and I'm still here.
It's actually starting to sound more and more than Katakana Chilo Shaka, actually. You were right. You were definitely right. So we went all over social media looking for those Zero Chill posts, and since it's this time of the year, most Zero Chill posts on social media were centered around Ezanyanga, Ezi Endangowari, like January, February. Yeah, but so Bosque, what?
No, I didn't know about February. I know about February.
It can be February, you know. So we kicked off the year again. Well, got you guys a post today. So Bascala gets stronger. A post from Ubaba giving us a Happy New Year message. Let's have a look at this one.
He didn't say he wants to be a mayor again, did he?
Happy 21 and 7,000.
Okay. Can you do the voice though? But can you do the
voice? How does the voice go?
Do you do the voice?
No, I don't know the voice. How is that?
No, do the voice, man.
You can do the voice.
Guys, I actually genuinely don't know.
I want to be mayor.
That's a good voice.
If I did it, and? I don't know. There would be flames. But then again, I'm a professional stand-up comedian. Then there's that. Geniuses. Anyway, so then someone posted that some of us started the year with bank balances looking like this.
Shame, man.
Shame. Who are these people? I don't know anyone.
Look there. Stop it. Balance is 22 rand. Available balance for 3 rand 89.
That's not even
airtime.
Hilarious.
Well, guys, it's all self-inflicted because you didn't need half the things that you spent.
You know what? We're not cool just because you had all the fun in the world and now you don't want us to have fun. We want to have fun in December. We're going to have fun.
Moderation.
Okay?
Moderation.
What's that? Is that an invigilator? Moderator.
Yeah, let's see. What kind of walk? Is that the moderation walk? Moderation.
Okay, continue, Miss Nina.
You know what? Yeah. You are a no-chill post.
Yeah.
Like, just you. Like.
All right, so for many of us, according to social media, this is what January means. January.
The
pregnancy... Yo.
Whoa.
The angry parents. The rich tavern owners.
Yeah.
That's great. That's funny. And so true.
I never thought about how much money tavern owners have now.
Yeah, well, hello.
Yeah.
Right now, it's boiling.
One of my cousins, like, is a tavern owner.
He's single.
Well, this is why you wanted that liquor board not to be.
No, I'm just saying. I'm just saying.
Continue when I'm mom.
And he does have a place in Soweto.
There's the Porsche. Bays have disappeared and have now... Mine still hasn't come back, so I don't know. Bays have disappeared and now return. Check this WhatsApp message.
I love this one.
Baby, I'm sorry. My phone was not working throughout December. Okay, mine really wasn't. I only just saw your missed calls. Okay, I only just saw them. I wish I spent my bonus money with you. I love you, and I'm coming back home on Sunday. Please help me with petrol and lunch money so that I can go back to work on Monday. Love you always. You are the ruler of my heart. I love you more than the festive season. You are the reason I live. Next year, I will spend December at home. I promise. All right.
You know what's funny about that? Like, we're probably, like, laughing. That's a real thing.
But what do you respond to that? What do you ladies respond to that and say?
I don't know. I just blocked somebody and went on holiday.
No, but that might have been a lady sending it to a dude.
Exactly.
Well, how would you respond?
What do you respond? How?
Ugly message.
You don't respond.
I wouldn't have seen it if she would have been blocked.
Exactly. Uh-huh. A long time ago. Tell us more about the no-chill post when I'm on.
Yeah. Let's talk about no-chill posts. Especially those dedicated to the Moreki. According to Tweeps and Bookers, Facebookers, Morekis across the country kicked this year off singing like Whitney.
I have nothing.
Don't let me close this wallet.
I don't wanna
hurt anymore.
Give us some money.
Take these cards and repay them. Oh, wow. Must I imagine
okay,
you
I
can?
Believe.
Wow, okay.
Don't walk away from me.
All right. We can. Yeah. Rikis,
I have nothing. Nothing.
Nothing.
Oh, wow, shout out to you. What's up, I'm dying anymore. So, some Murekis still have something. There's Murekis out there who might just need ingatolotu because some Murekis are no longer Murekis. They are now Aba Bolekis, except for Shaka, obviously. Like one Murekis out of lotion. Sega Mboleki. Let's have a look at this. Yeah, and some of them are actually even out of groceries. Let's have a look at what they eat in Gochadwari. There's pap and ice.
Shame.
No. Shame. That's real, guys.
What's that?
There's rice and bologna.
Bologna and rice.
Wow, okay. And then there's also rice and chicken. You can imagine the chicken if you need to.
Many people were living like kings after those December bonuses. And now that it's January, people are living like paupers. Check this post out. It's all your fault, self-inflicted. Dan Maswangane, 16 December, eating pap and steak, drinking skull vodka, music playing, King Manoda Moreki, December 25th, eating Voss chicken fish. Let's go to January 10. Eating beans, cabbage, and acha, drinking water, playing Zahara, Impilo, guys, really. And because January has showed many South Africans flames, here is a letter, a plea sent to all political parties via social media. Now, dear ANC, EFF, DN, all other political parties would like to propose that we get our bonuses on the 15th of January, starting from 2018. We realize that receiving it in December is causing a lot of inconvenience for us and our families. Kindly get this message to the president as well. I mean, really, be responsible, guys. Come on. I mean, we may be laughing, we may be joking because, you
but
know, those kind of
I
people
mean,
we are.
Question.
But you need to be responsible because obviously the most important thing are your kids and your business.
There's something really wrong with our system. If you get your money on the 15th or the 20th of December, and it has to last all the way till the 30th of January.
Are you not an adult? Are we giving this money to infants?
We should be able
all
to
the way
better.
Through
do you not know how to
December.
Budget?
No, you know what's happening with the money. People are eating it. They're just like eating it. You know, like they just start answering weird things. They'll answer your phone, you'll answer a cup, you'll answer a tablet. What? You'll be like, chocolates, you'll answer a shoe.
And tell us about no chill.
Now we said earlier on about 2017, each no chilling has crossed over. We thought it was something we're going to live in 2016, and it has actually crossed over to 2017. Like, have a look at this video.
Hello, how are you? thank you.
I'm fine, thank you. Can I please have chill?
Hello?
Ngicela chill.
A chill?
Yebo.
Can you not help?
Anna, I chill.
No.
And then you got in.
Eh?
You got in.
I have not song and lotto.
Can't take you one like her.
So, oh, that's hilarious.
So if you're still hopeful that we're going to find some chill boy, we have some bad news for you, because this guy went looking for a chill, also ifuna nekoti nefuti, but still nothing was available. Check this out.
Where can I find chill? Sanbonan bosses nijan. But ngicela ukubuza, ngathola phi chill?
Chill.
Yeah, chill like I need tengise la chill ngoba nje ngathi iyafuneka na yiko.
You mean chillies?
It chill, like chuma it chill.
No, like chill.
Like kono munyu si sengi mkwendi koti na tsa rai chengi isma nyas buzu kutu kante gyuan lai kaya. No, I maran yan po, nane.
Okay, anyway, before we end this no chill segment, a lot of you have been asking to see more of that Van Damme video that we showed you on Tuesday. Remember that one?
I know he loves himself too much.
Yeah, when Van Damme was loving Van Damme.
He's in the tracksuit pants and he's like.
Yes, yeah.
He was doing the fertility dance.
He was.
Okay, exactly. Anyway, I want to show you guys the second half of that clip. Check it out.
His poor wife and his poor children.
Breadwinner.
Wow, with that, folks, we definitely need to pray for #NoChill. Now for a quick break, when we return, we'll bring you more of those hashtags that kept our timelines on fire of the drag queen going through that. #100 heartbreaking lyrics. Share yours with us. Star on 3 is the hashtag. On Twitter, TrendingSA on 3. On Facebook, TrendingSA. On Instagram, TrendingSA. Sisaya Bulala Uvan Jam will be back after this. Well, obviously not me, but these guys.
Dale. Dila, dila.
This is my day. This is my day.
You are watching us on SABC 3 and on TrendingSA.tv. TrendingSA is the name of the show. We tackle all things social media, especially trending hashtags. And now we delve into
hashtags. Why are you holding this guy's hand? Don't molest him.
It's
no, she's a raper.
It's fun.
It's fun.
She's also a raper. Okay.
Right, so into a hashtag 100 heartbreaking lyrics was trended earlier this week. But before we even discuss that, some believe that social media is a huge force behind breakups. Here's a Prince KB, for instance, with Wajelwa. Yeah. Wajelwa,
Wajelwa. Facebook, Wajelwa. Twitter, Wajelwa.
The song is coming.
Nazo.
What's up, Wajelwa? Didn't do.
Why do you look so suspicious, Lena?
Because, I mean, my phone is lit. It's going down in the DMs, guys. So it's actually bad. Anyway,
DM Wajelwa. Facebook Wajelwa. DMs Wajelwa. What's up?
Boy.
Wajelwa.
100 heartbreaking lyrics. So in December...
I remember when women were good. Now they're like you guys. When?
I'm good.
In 1442.
Listen to me. In 1932, Mae West said, when I'm good, I'm good. But when I'm bad, I'm better.
Anyway,
so in December, we spoke a lot about...
She was.
Whatever. I'm not. No. In December, we spoke a lot about how people break up with you or disappear. They go play with the Nyatsis over the holidays. That happened to me once. I was so mad. Anyway, I had bought him a telescope. A telescope for Christmas, and he leaves me in Christmas in Rustenburg to go with the telescope with a Nyatsi. I couldn't deal. Anyway.
Oh, so, and then they went on the hill and then they looked at the sky.
Yes, with my telescope.
Yeah, because the Nazi told me.
I know, because. Anyway.
Okay, when a mama went anyway, so, I don't antagonize her.
Hey. only to return this week. Then they come back. Then they've got all these excuses. Okay, now, the people that know on Facebook, Wajelwa. On Twitter, Wajelwa. Even Cisco once sang a song, Somebody sleeping in my bed.
Messing with my head. And you.
I don't even want to think about it. It's disgusting. Okay, so we've decided to share some heartbreaking lyrics that those mending their broken hearts can use to shame their returning partners. But before that, though, let's see how this hashtag 100 breaking lyrics started. Akumzi.
So, right? A tweet. So there was a tweet that went out with the hashtag 100 heartbreaking lyrics, right? So this was first posted on the 28th of December by Sibley_Mzizi. Okay. And the tweet was like this. Let's see what it looked like. So hashtag 100 heartbreaking lyrics. When I'm gone, don't mind. Right. So people then by London, I get up and the hashtag gained momentum. And on Tuesday, that is the 3rd of January, right? Mm. It engaged more people and people continue to share more and more and more posts using the hashtag 100 heartbreaking lyrics. And people have shared songs like Let's Just Kiss
and say goodbye.
And say goodbye.
We're gonna do that at the end of the show.
And then there was also It's Too Late by Dolly Parton.
Nice.
And then another one was People Change Their Minds and People Change Their Hearts with the Season, and that's by Emily Sunday. What other songs?
Shagalalas.
I Wish by Toni Braxton comes to mind.
How's that?
I don't know how that goes.
In the first year.
Yes. Okay, you know what? That's a boring song. Okay.
What else?
You know what the classic song is?
What?
How do I...
You guys
are supposed to go... say goodbye. What we had.
I think you're mixing up.
No, it's a song. The good times that made us laugh.
We have another one. How about this one? How could an angel break my heart?
Ding, 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 ding.
Oh, that song is
beautiful. Let me show you exactly how an angel could break your heart. Now, check this tweet out that I laughed about all through the holiday. Check this tweet out.
Can we continue?
All right. Right.
Received okay. SMS
so Ukhulufelo says, I received 2 SMSs from Bay. The first SMS was, let's break up now. It's all over. Then the second SMS was, oh, so sorry. That was not for you.
So Gladys sees
other people. Thought I was confused.
Should you be happy or not? Like.
And then of course we have, oh, like the late Whitney Houston did. She said goodbye. What did she say?
She said
goodbye.
Please. Don't cry. We both know I'm not what you need.
But I'm wishing you die.
And no! You're supposed to do the thing like
oh,
this.
Oh, and the lips.
Guys, I've been good this year. I don't deserve this torture. You were saying when
I'm
mom.
Yeah, guys, I'm freaked out. And I'm sure that the viewers are as well. Sorry, yeah. Guys. Anyway, back to me. Okay, I'd rather do a better one. Just make it fast, quick, and, you know, like Queen Bey. You know, put your hand up high and be like, boy, bye. You know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
I don't know how the song
tell
goes.
Him exactly. Bye.
Tell him bye.
Tell
boy,
him bye.
Hey.
Oh, bye.
Bye.
You know? Might not understand.
Also, when but when you're dating boys, that's what you have to do.
What? Tell them bye.
Tell them bye. Date a man.
But you know what's funny? It shows that you're dating boys if you have to do hand signals. Like when you're having relationship talk, boy, bye. What's that?
And tell us about the, if we might not understand it if he's a sportsman.
You might not understand it if he's a sportsman. Mm. Yeah. So, but check this out. When a paga paga, when Zenjan. When ma paga paga.
Also, chances he's not coming
again,
back.
Again, we're tell it.
If he's broke, akazubuya, so muregi dololo, and this is what you say when he comes back broke. Akiri wena, auna tell it.
Okay. Wait, which song is this? I can't make up the song. Yeah. What song is it? Akiri wena, auna tell it.
House.
Is that like, yeah?
Is it
in the Mureki
song?
Yeah, it's a line there.
Oh, damn.
Guys, we wish all the best with those heartbreaking songs you'll be singing with your returning bays. While we're still on the gospel tip, Shaka's Ridge, make fun with some Christian stories through hashtag meme history.
I'm always ready to make fun of something Christian.
How?
Yeah? What?
Around Christmas, I was rolling.
Put your hand on your face when you cough.
Yes.
That's so gross.
So disgusting.
See, if you were a Christian, shocking. You would know that.
Yeah. I feel it as one of your angels was like in the back. This is like spiritual blood coming out. Okay, over Christmas, I was on the floor laughing about the hashtag meme history. It was created by a guy called Tyler Lamar.
Tyler Lamar.
When he came across a meme using a teacher's presentation on Adolf Hitler. Yeah.
Let's see.
How did Hitler feel about territory?
Feel.
About territory.
I need this.
I really feel like I've messed up that joke. I'm really sorry.
It's just fine.
I really messed up. I've messed that up. Okay, I messed
it
up. Okay,
you know what? So, you know what? Let's continue.
So I'm going to show you another one, okay? Because you get it. What am I explaining to you? Things you understand.
Wow. So let's see another one.
Let's see another one. Let's see another one.
Let's see another one.
Okay, meme mystery. Yeah. Isaac says, Father, the wood and the fire are here, but where is the lamb for the offering? Abraham looking at his son like
nice.
That's very clever. That's very clever.
Okay, Mary, we had to explain to Joseph. No, baby, I wanna. No, baby. No, I've never had sex. No, I did not cheat on you. No. No,
brilliant.
How? No, get Jesus.
He
no,
was
get
a God. How
it's
could
God.
I?
It's
how
God.
Could I?
It's God.
God.
All the way.
What
okay.
about Cain?
Yeah, Cain. I like that. I like this meme. Check this meme out.
What did...
The slave master's wife when she saw a mixed kid on the plantation.
Daddy's
been busy. And you know what? The slave master's wife probably had a mustache as well. Look at how Moses looked at his mother when she was dropping in the river. Mom, come on. Mom, come on. Check this one out.
Brilliant.
Check this one out. Okay. Aren't you one of Jesus' disciples? Peter's like, nah. Me. But nah.
Yeah, Peter. Never.
And 3 times at that.
Never. Yeah, you know what I like about it when Ashakalalas is that if you don't know the Bible, it will reiterate it and also make it more relatable.
Let me tell you what I like about it. It's funny.
Yeah.
All right, so this hashtag made us think of like popular memes that we use all the time. People have like memes for... You know, our famous people.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, you know, let's check it out.
Like Zambia. Yeah.
Like.
Nah.
Ooh, shame.
Yeah.
Put it away.
That's hilarious, right?
Yeah. Nina, let's go to the... Nina, what do you have for us? Nina, what do you have for us?
She is traumatized.
Anyone can become a meme if caught at the right moment, including SABC's Cloudy. He has a lot of those moments here.
Yeah. All right, so there's another one. If I was Yama Memes, then I don't know what rock you've been living under, because Umnami Apake is our president, President Jacob Zuma. Let's have a look at some of the memes that are supposed to be. The crowd loves me. They even call me.
See, that's the song. See, that's the joke.
I finally got the voice. The crowd loved me. Like, you have
is
to
that, say. Oh, is that the voice? No.
The crowd loved me.
And then hashtag them. Number four, so many memes and so little time. So I'll end my list with one of the pros of President Mugabe. He's been getting memes. Look at this. I know it's not statue. Look at that. When the beat drops. Yeah, baby. Yeah, baby. Yeah, baby. Shake your body like a snake.
Guys, I think these are classics. These are classics. We need to be giving these things like gold medals. That one in the karakara like circle, the power circle. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
It needs a gold medal or something, a star.
You need a gold medal for looking so handsome tonight. We need a break. We're going to have to look at Ushaga.
I've got rappers to SMS, guys.
But look at Ushaga. Look at how
and what about the rapers?
Ushaga, you are so beautiful. It's a pity that you're single. Guys, we'll see you after the break. You know where to catch us.
Wait. Are you not in single men?
No. We are not in single men. We're meant to married men. Catch us. Hashtag onsa. TrendingSA onsa on Twitter, on Instagram, and on Facebook. After the break, it is all hip hop with Tweezy. Shaga. So your girlfriend,
you really is. You're not really married, are you? And you don't really love your girlfriend.
This is my day. This is my day. I got dreams, I got ambition. Just the young and trying to get. My nigga, I'm all I'm in the game. Cut us of the whole city in the game. Hey. I got dreams, I got ambition. Just the young and trying to get. My nigga, I'm all.
TrendingSA on 3 and on TrendingSA.tv. Nina's done it again, and she's brought another one of her lit friends. He's very talented as well.
Yeah, I don't know him though. He's not my friend. I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay, fine. Not well, yet. You know, he's a nice guy. Not yet. He hasn't got your number. He's not down the DMs yet. You know, give us 10 minutes.
Ladies and gentlemen, Tweezy's in the
Welcome home.
Okay, so he's the man behind some of the hottest tunes in Mzansi. Some of you might know him as Tweezy, the Dreamer. I know him as SA's best producer as for the Hip Hop Awards, which I hosted. And he's come far from his ghetto prophecy days, all of 5 years ago. Ooh, that was so back in the day. And today he's sitting with us because he's kicked off 2017 on a high by dropping his new trendy single, Jumanji.
Jumanji.
Yeah.
Okay, so he's a rapper. He's a producer. He's not my friend yet, but he will be, I'm sure. His name is Tweezy. Okay, so Tweezy. Is that because you pluck your beard? Is that where that name comes from?
No, it comes from In Tweezy, which comes from In 20. That was a nickname I got in high school. Oh. Yeah.
Wait.
In 20 because
were you in your 20s in high school?
that's exactly
no.
What I was
29.
In grade 8 at the NSA, I went to the National School of the Arts. Yeah. So I used to have this jacket, AA Network. So it had N this side and it had the number 20 this side. Yeah. So it was kind of like an identity thing. Yo, do you know Tumelo? No, N20. Oh, yeah, that guy. I've seen him.
As in, you never took the jacket off?
You never took it off.
Nah, it was my cool, man.
Well, you know the smell of lingering.
Stinky. Jokey.
Oh, wow.
All right. Okay. So, look. So, let's just go. Let's jump back to 2016. Okay. You were the center of quite a lot of controversy. Mm-hmm. There was a lot of artists that you produced for last year. Okay. Yeah. So, you claimed that they weren't giving you the credit for your tracks. Ayilber. One of the artists was AKA for All Eyes on Me and for Run Josie. Then he went onto Twitter and he started saying, okay, I'm going to read this, guys. Tweezy only helped me. Tweezy only helped. I can't do his voice. Tweezy only helped me with the drums on Baddest, for instance. Don't let that Ayober tag fool you. I put it on there so he could shine. Okay, so what did he say? Here it is. Okay, so I would appreciate. Then another one was, I would appreciate it if Tweezy could stop introducing himself as the person who made my songs. I need to see you made the songs. Those are collaborative efforts. Okay, then another tweet was, Tweezy needs to stop talking about me in interviews if he's going to block me on Twitter. I don't understand. So that's a lot. Like, how did you deal with that, my darling?
You blocked him?
Yeah.
Who blocks AKA? Yes.
I do.
Ooh!
He must be respected. He's okay.
No,
he's
the thing is, you know, the whole controversy of credits was based on just South African producers overall.
Right.
How everyone just sleeps on how we work hard and we just the producers and we don't really get the credit that we
do. Yeah, but you get paid for it.
We do.
So?
Yeah, but you get credit as well.
But, I mean, when we do the song, there's a producer, just like Sambro. You know, you get a songwriter's royalty and you get a composer's royalty.
Oh.
So I feel like with everything that happens with the song, it should be so.
Of course.
You know, so when it's an award, whether it's a, yo, man, that's a nice song. Yo, nice beat.
You remind me of these photographers who are like, no, credit the photographer, credit the photographer.
But
you're getting paid for the damn thing.
What you need to understand is we need to get our, for us to move on with our business, it comes good when you're like, yo, I'm the guy that was mentioned at the summit, for instance.
Oh, so you're just doing it for fame?
Not
you
really.
Guys, recognition. You
for
guys
recognition.
Are biting the hand that feeds you for fame.
I understand.
The
I
fact
understand.
That you can't recognize me for the work that I'm doing means that you don't appreciate what I'm doing.
Great!
Didn't I make an album with your song? Didn't I make an album and put your song on the album?
Yeah, but I worked so many hours making that beat it's a hit.
It's a week.
So, fast forwarding past all of that now, right? Because it's a pelum song up in there. And then you made your own track, right? The one we just played moments ago, Ambition. Tell us a little bit more about that track.
So it's my first single, man.
It's stunning, babe.
I decided that I'd step out as an artist because, I mean, I've been doing the producer thing for a while.
Mm.
So I've always wanted to be an artist, but I figured, let me just start being a producer, be a great producer, be recognized for it. Then eventually I'd introduce my
artist. Is that like Timbaland? Did he do that?
Kind of like, Timbaland for real,
Now let's get to know you a bit better. Your real name is Tumelo. How do you say it?
Tumelo.
Did you? Was it hard? Did you hurt yourself?
Nah, it was quite easy.
Okay, we like it. Your name is Tumelo and you changed it because it was cool?
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, as a rapper, you need to have an
alias. Are there just too many Tumelos around? There was too many Tumelos.
No, but listen.
Yeah, but imagine I'm a rapper. I'm hardcore. My name is Tumelo.
Yeah, but yeah. Whoa. Imagine you're a rapper, you're hardcore, your name is Tweezy.
I like that.
Tweezy, it's got like some.
You could have been.
No, I'm just saying. Hardcore.
I mean, imagine you are Red Winner and your name is Shaga Laga. Anyway, Kara.
No, I want to know about
my name is Shaga Susu.
What happens to Tweezy when you're with your woman, you know? Hey, Tweezy.
No, it sounds like a playboy name, not a hardcore rapper name.
No, but the thing is, you know, there's personal life Tweezy and there's brand Tweezy.
Yeah.
So in its personal lifetime, I'm not Tweezy, I'm Tumelo. You know? And then obviously when you're in the spotlight, then you become Tweezy.
So when your girlfriends fight with you, they shout, what to me?
When my mom is chikaring me in the house for not washing the dishes or whatever. Tumelo, come wash these dishes.
I'll go to Tweezy.
Tweezy, come wash these
dishes. Yo, Tweezy. Nah, yo, Tweezy.
You know, look, we're talking about like your past, right? You were part of a group called Ghetto Prophecy.
Yeah.
About 6 years
Ghetto
ago.
Ghetto Prophecy? You were part of Ghetto Prophecy?
Yeah, you just said that.
Well, I did. Sorry.
Yeah. And then you had a song, Oh My.
Yeah. Right?
I want everyone that doesn't know, Oh My, here's Oh My.
Yo, I sure was laughing in the yo.
I remember this.
I'm a champion.
What? Wait, do you still like it? Yeah, you sure he is a
perfect 10. Black beauty marvel. This was that when everyone was wearing Wayfarers with the different colors in the caps.
Yeah.
Right now, what happened to the group?
The era,
are they all in Ekurule?
Yeah. What was the Cream Cartel era?
Pretty much.
Mm. Where are they, the group members?
They're in Jozi, where we really did our thing, you know. So, I mean, obviously, not everyone is in the same wavelength in a group. And that's very important because, you know, like Tear Gas, everyone had the same mission. And, you know, they stuck to the mission and the vision and they worked out. So in a group,
did they do a SWOT analysis?
What? Pretty much, yeah. They just figured themselves out and they said, you know what, we're all going to be determined to make this thing work.
Also, they were related, so that helped.
Take us the group that's not together anymore.
Well,
the mission there.
Oh, yeah, the mission there.
Okay, but
yes,
listen, how do you feel that coming, being the guy that makes it out of this group of four?
You feel sort of did,
did you know? Did you know that you were going to be the Beyonce?
Not really. I wasn't looking at that. I mean, you know, I mean, I had people saying, yo, you're so talented. You make beats, you rap. Yo, you the Beyonce of the group. And I'm just like, yo, we're trying to make it together. You know, humble, teamwork, team spirit. And then eventually, you know, just out of obviously commitment and who's trying to make it work more than the other. You know?
Why does the camera pan to Nina? At that point.
So then, since you've made it big, you are happening and hot. If they came for assistance, like for a loan, like don't run you and Ongababa.
No, of course they're my friends. I mean, at the end of the day.
Guys,
so.
Call up. You know where he is. He's willing to give you guys some money.
Yeah. And we're still in connection. You
guys
know?
hang out together.
Yeah,
it's cool because you're hanging out. Then you're like, listen, I gotta go. I got a gig.
What do you guys have to do?
You're hanging out.
Well, one is a music manager, and the other one also is an artist, so we're not really far off in terms of,
That's cool. That's very cool.
Okay, so you rap about all this. You've had a like tumultuous time. You've had your own struggles. You rap about it in Jumanji. But before we do that, okay. Oh, wait. You and one of your group members, EJ, got together for a song that took Twitter by storm now recently. There were 41,000 downloads in less than 24 hours. That's a lot. That's like, those are big numbers. Can I show you guys a clip of that? Hey, hashtag Bonang. Why you answer so?
Hey, Bonang. This is a whole subtweet. Why you answer? Like a whole song.
I'm traumatized, and very confused. What's the song about Bonang?
It's a name.
Not really. Bonang is a common name.
But it also means. No, Bonang also means Shebang, okay? Like,
look.
Yeah.
Okay.
Look, the song is not mine, so I don't know, Vela, about the concepts and everything. I know that I was the producer of the song.
Wait. So the guy is doing the song and telling you as a producer how he wants the song. He's not telling you the concept.
Yeah, of course they tell the concept. And when the song comes together, when you feel like, you know what, this is catchy and it's a nice song, you know, despite the controversy that
I still don't know what's happening.
Controversy sells. Let's just leave it there.
Also.
Nana, you're doing fantastically. Where can people catch you if they want to, like, perv, or if they want to, like, get to know you, or if they want to be like you?
Well, my handle everywhere is TweezyZA. Mm-hmm. That's TweezyZA on all social media platforms here, right there on the screen.
Can you give us your phone number? What is it, 08?
Yeah, let's
072.
Okay, we're going to the break. The number is only for us because, I mean, she's thirsty. Thank you very much. We're not letting him go. We're going to hang out with him. You know where to catch us. Stay tuned. The weekend is about to officially begin. My name is Cooley Roberts. I'm with rock stars. We'll see you just now. Hashtag Star13. On Twitter, we are TrendingSA. On Instagram, we are TrendingSA. On Facebook, we are
TrendingSA.
We'll touch you guys just now. This is my day.
This is my day.
Thank you for allowing us to keep you company on this lovely Friday evening. This is Trending SA on SABC3 and on TrendingSA.tv, the show where no trending hashtag goes unnoticed. Shakalala, you still have your Mr. Yeah, Lover Lover right next to you.
The one thing we did not discuss, right, Mr. was that Bombastic. On Tuesday, Jumanji trended for 2 days, right?
Pretty much.
Pretty much. And that's your new single. Mm-hmm. It has been crazy. How many downloads? You know how many downloads? You haven't counted yet.
I haven't
yet.
Really checked. I was so focused on pushing it. I haven't even checked
it. You guys
the
have pushed this thing hard. You had everyone on promo Twitter on this thing.
Gotta do what you gotta do.
Listen, but you know what it is? I mean, I think I saw a lot of people tweeting about it after they'd heard it, and they actually genuinely like the track. What's the thing that you're trying to do with Jumanji?
Yeah. Well, with Jumanji, I mean, with all of my music, I'm just trying to spread a message, you know, because yeah. I'm from Ilokishi Nechablani, and there's a whole lot of people that aspire to be something, but they're not really courageous to.
Are you from Jablani?
Take... Yeah.
I used to do comedy there at Ozone every Wednesday.
Ozone. Yeah.
Anyway, Karen.
Anyway, so yeah, yes. I mean. My mission is to encourage people from Ekaslam, obviously, to not be fearful of their decisions.
I
and
love that.
To take that giant leap of faith and work hard to making their things happen.
It's an epic thing.
Yeah.
All right, okay, when are we seeing you, like, in concert? Where are you performing next?
I mean, I'm performing at the clubs and stuff, wherever I'm booked. I mean, this
you
weekend.
Dab?
Yeah, dab. Yo.
Did you get permission I'm to use the Jumanji logo? Get permission to use the Jumanji logo?
Listen.
Look at him.
You just use it.
Yo, if they want to say something, let's talk about it. We'll figure it out.
Yeah, you know what? It'll be great publicity.
Wait, hold on a second. Are you the person asking for credit and then you are borrowing other people's things?
Nina.
Guys, you are absolutely incredible. Tweezy, I'm going to see you tomorrow at Kaya. Thank you very much for coming through. What are you guys doing this weekend? What are you doing this weekend, Tweezy?
Gigs. Work. I need to finish up my mixtape. I'm busy mixing and mastering, so yeah.
Okay, no. Don't make that my problem. I'm still
wait, who's on? Who's on it? Who's on your mixtape?
It's just me because, I mean, it's my exposure at being an artist.
Are you not featuring
I'm focusing on myself.
All right. No. And you're doing this with Ambitious Records?
No, just me.
Just you?
I'm independent, yeah. So
oh, you're independent?
Just me. Yeah.
Okay, and then who's distributing for you?
Yo.
All right, let's talk. Let's talk after the show. Yeah. Anyway,
nice,
thanks,
Kili. Nice. What are you doing this weekend? Oh, yeah.
Really?
Wow. Sorry.
Can I tell you what I'm doing this weekend?
No, I'm burying my uncle, Kuli.
Yeah, okay. I was just asking, does it count? Because it was in the script, does it count?
I want to tell you guys what I'm doing this weekend. Can I tell you?
Hello, I didn't ask. Wait.
Oh.
Akumzi, what are you doing this weekend? Hi, ladies first.
Okay.
I'm going back home. I'm gonna be.
I would never diss you.
I'm going back home to Pretoria. I'm gonna be Mamelodi. It's gonna be so cool with all my school friends from Willow Ridge and Vinnie Da Vinci and a whole bunch of other people. It's gonna be great.
Nice, what are you doing?
Nice, nice. On Saturday. It's a house gig in Mums, and I'm gonna be emceeing the gig.
What are you doing, Momo? Cool.
I'm finally chilling and doing absolutely nothing this weekend since December started. Hey, it's been hard.
When my melody
yeah, because you did come
so
Tuesday.
It's,
that was nice.
Thank you.
35 December Beach Party, Hinterland Avenue Park, Mamelodi East, featuring all kinds of things. Check out my social media, I'll let you know.
Fantastic, there we go. They're absolutely incredible.
Wait, what about
you
this
are team? Wonderful. You told us, we started with him. Ushagalala, there's something wrong with him. But hey, what
yes, yes, because I'm bringing my uncle tomorrow.
Oh, sorry.
Guys, we love you. It's now time for our weekend to begin. We love you. We love you, Akumzi. Akumzi, yes, we're nothing without you. Thank you. We love you so much. Thank you so much, Nina. You are fantastic. Tweezy, I love you the most. Akumzi must go so I can hug you. Come on, Tweezy, come to me. Come to me. Come to me.
I love you. Bye.
Bye.
Nina, jump in.
Nina, jump in. If you want to get a hold of us on Twitter, it's TrendingSA. On Instagram, it's TrendingSA. On Facebook, it's TrendingSA. And yes, it's TrendingSA right here on SABC3.
Cocoa, 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 coc this is my day.